Hello everybody, just going to have a little fly around. See if I can take off on this short runway, very much doubt it. Let's turn these engines up a bit. That gets a take off. I think the runway's long enough. Very good. Oh, I like taking off from a better. Gotcha. We're never gonna land there. Try that. That's gonna work. Go for it. See if this one works. Sorry about that. Didn't realize this plane took such a big runway. All these four engines started. Are they all running? Flaps. Show you the views in this one. Passenger view or co-pilot in the tunnel. Cool. 52 frames seconds, not too bad. She's a slow one. Retract the flaps. And she's room. Start leveling off a little bit. What a view. Just going to start a little bit of music if I can. Copilot seat. Not sure how long this will be for, probably. So I'm all on my own, there's no other players around. This plane was a British long-range maritime patrol aircraft, which is used by the Royal Air Force and also the South African Air Force. It was developed by Avro from the Lincoln Bomber. It's developed in the late 40s. Operational shows 1951. So first flight in 1949, the introduction in 1951, and I retired it in 1991. It was only produced for 7 years, from 1951 to 58, courtesy of Wikipedia. We just turn it around a little bit. Quite low, nearly 8,000 feet. Cruising around about 175 knots. We'll be going over the mountains. Wow. It's glorious. Just joining us, welcome. 1940s, 50s, Avro Shackleton. So we are flying sort of northwest America. Feet, still climbing at 170 knots. Cockpit. A FSX port over to flight simulator. Different views. 2D panel there. Co-pilot seat. I think the leather's getting a bit worn, needs a bit of treatment on it. There we go. Climbing. fuel lasts forever, these things.